one of the hardest thumbnails I ever had to make, and I'm all red because of it. But anyway, my name's Aviva, and welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to talk to you guys about the Shadowhunter Chronicles and how I recommend reading it. I'm making this video right now because next week the newest release in the Shadowhunters universe is coming out. It's called Chain of Iron, and it's the second book in the Last Hour series, which I'll get to in a little bit. But basically, I wanted to explain how I read the Shadowhunter Chronicles and how I recommend reading it. But in case you're new to this universe and you're not really sure what it's about, it's basically an urban fantasy about these demon hunting warriors. That is the simplest way I can explain what this universe is about. But obviously, each series, they have their own set of characters. There's a lot of romance going on, and it's one of my favorite series. So if you're new to this universe, I recommend reading this in chronological order. That's how I read it, and I'm extremely happy that I did it that way, mostly because I didn't want to be spoiled for anything. And reading it chronologically, you basically get to meet each character as they were introduced into the universe. You don't get any spoilers, and you can kind of follow the story in its timeline as it happened, as everything was going on. And this is in no way the correct order to read it. This is just how I read it. I enjoy reading it this way, and therefore that is how I recommend you reading it if you are just jumping into the world as well. So the first series I recommend reading is the Infernal Devices series, which is The Clockwork Angel, The Clockwork Prince, and The Clockwork Princess. And I believe this series would technically be considered a historical fantasy series because it takes place in the 1800s. And this series is about a girl named Tessa who arrives in Victorian London and comes across the Shadowhunters from the London Institute. And there she finds out that her life is a little bit more entwined with the downworld than she ever realized. And one of the best things about this series is the romance. There's a lot going on in this series. It's really good, and it's an amazing introduction to the Shadowhunter world. What I really loved about it is that Tessa doesn't know anything about the Shadowhunters, and therefore you get to learn about the world with her. Therefore, I think it's a great introduction book to the series. It's also one of the best in my opinion. And therefore, if you liked this series, you'll get hooked enough to want to make it through all of the other books. So one thing I just want to note is that the epilogue of The Clockwork Princess technically takes place after some events that happen in the Mortal Instruments series. So you're technically going to get a minor spoiler by reading this before the next one. But I'll explain it a little bit more in detail once we get to that next book. So the next series in the timeline is the Last Hour series, which is currently Chain of Gold, and the new release that's coming out next week, which is Chain of Iron. And this series is about the children of the characters from the Infernal Devices. And I'm going to admit and tell you guys that I actually skipped this book when I was reading the entire universe, because I knew that there was going to be a cliffhanger at the end of this book, and I had read all of this back in November, and the new release is coming out the first week of March. So I decided I'm gonna put this book on the side, and when Chain of Iron comes out, I'm just gonna read Chain of Gold and Chain of Iron back to back. So I personally skipped this book when I was reading the entire universe, but now that Chain of Iron is coming out, I would definitely recommend reading Chain of Gold and Chain of Iron right here, because this is where it fits into the timeline, and the next book isn't coming out for an entire year. But if you're watching this sometime in the future, you should definitely read the entire Last Hour series right here, because this is where it fits into the timeline. And after you read The Infernal Devices, you get to read about their children, and it's going to be amazing to be able to read that back to back. And the next series to read in the timeline is the Mortal Instruments series, which is actually the first series that came out in this universe. And this series is 6 books: The City of Bones, The City of Ashes, The City of Glass, The City of Fallen Angels, The City of Lost Souls, and the last book, The City of Heavenly Fire. Mortal Instruments series is about a girl named Clary Fairchild who, like Tessa from the Infernal Devices, is unaware about the Shadowhunter universe. And she comes across the Shadowhunters from the New York Institute, and the story goes from there. And so according to the timeline, I would actually split this series up into 2. I would first read the first 3 books, which is The City of Bone, The City of Ashes, and then The City of Glass. And then I would pick up The Red Scrolls of Magic by Cassandra Clare and Wedgley Chu. which is a small story about two characters from the Mortal Instruments named Magnus and Alec, and they go on this epic adventure. And this book happens to take place in between the City of Glass and the City of Fallen Angels. So according to the timeline, I would pause the Mortal Instruments and read this right here. What's also a great thing about doing this is that the Mortal Instruments is kind of split into like two moments. There's a war that happens and it kind of gets concluded. And then the next three books are kind of like the aftermath of what happened in the first three. So you could really pause right here and read this without feeling like you're pausing in a series and pushing like a random book in the middle. It really does flow really well. Plus, the Mortal Instruments is so big that it kind of helps to get a breather and a little bit more of like a lighter epic adventure story with Magnus and Alec in between the two heavy Mortal Instruments series. So after the Red School of Magic, I'd pick up the next three Mortal Instruments books, which is The City of Fallen Angels, The City of Lost Souls, and The City of Heavenly Fire. And this is the spot where I mentioned before, where the things that happen in this book happen before the epilogue in this book. But it really isn't a big deal, and I just thought I'd mention it that there's gonna be a minor spoiler. The next book in the timeline to read is The Tales from the Shadowhunter Academy, which is a collection of short stories based around a character named Simon who's from the Mortal Instruments series. A lot of people think that this book is like not mandatory to read, and it's just a bunch of short stories about the characters from the Infernal Devices, from the Last Hour series, and from the Mortal Instruments series. But I really have to say that I think that this should be a mandatory read as an epilogue to the Mortal Instruments series, especially if you're reading this in chronological order. Reading this book right here won't give anything away to anything that happens in the future, but it has short stories about characters from the previous series. Also, it's an amazing story about Simon as a character and what he does after the Mortal Instruments series. And if you think like, oh, I'm just gonna pass on this book because short stories isn't really my thing, I really recommend you not doing that, because this is really an amazing book. It really concludes Simon as a character very well, and I think it is definitely very important to the universe as a whole. And the next book to read in the timeline is The Bane Chronicles. And my reasoning for reading this here is because even though the short stories that happen in this book happen throughout history, some of them start before the Infernal Devices, some of them happen in between the Infernal Devices, in between the Mortal Instruments series, it goes all over the place. But the last short story in this book doesn't take place until after the events from the Tales of the Shadowhunter Academy. And therefore, chronologically, this is the spot to read this book in. So the next book in the timeline to read is The Lost Book of the White, which is the second book to the Eldest Curses series. The first book was The Red Scrolls of Magic, which chronologically you're supposed to read in between the Mortal Instruments series. Even though it's the second book to this series, it takes place years later, where Magnus and Alec go on another adventure. And it takes place after all of the events from the previous books I've mentioned, and therefore this is the spot to read it in. Also because the events that happen here will later be talked about in the next series. So the last series in the Shadowhunter universe to read is The Dark Artifices, which is three very large books. It's Lady Midnight, Lord of Shadows, and Queen of Air and Darkness. And this series is about Emma Carstairs and Julian Blackthorn, who you'll meet at the end of the Mortal Instruments series. This series takes place like a few years after the end of the Mortal Instruments series, and you follow a bunch of characters from the London Institute, and a lot of characters from the previous series make appearances in here, and this is a great series as well. And the last book in the Shadowhunters universe that is currently published at the time I'm making this video is Ghost of the Shadow Market. And this book is about Jem Carstairs, who we originally meet in the Infernal Devices series. And this is a collection of short stories about him that take place throughout the entire timeline of the Shadowhunter universe. I don't want to give away any spoilers, so I'm not really going to say anything more than that. But this is an amazing book about Jem, who you're going to come to love once you start reading the universe. And while this book is not necessarily a mandatory read to understand the whole universe, I really think that Jem is a beloved character by many. And if you're okay with Tales from the Shadowhunter Academy and the Bane Chronicles, there's no reason you shouldn't pick this book up as well, because it was great. It had some amazing short stories about Chem, and I really enjoyed this book as well. And according to my knowledge, there is one more series that is going to be released for the Shadowhunters universe before Cassandra Clare calls it quits. And it's going to be called the Wicked Power series. And it's going to be about a character named Kit Herondale, who we meet in the Dark Artifices series. And it's going to take place, obviously, after the Dark Artifices series. And I am extremely excited about it, but there's currently no release date. I believe that the first book is not going to be coming out for at least a year or two, but it has been officially announced as the last series of the Shadowhunters universe. So I'm very excited for the Wicked Powers whenever it does decide to come into the world. And that is every single book that is currently published from the Shadowhunters universe in chronological order. So I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I hope you have a little bit more of an idea of how to jump into the Shadowhunters universe now. And if you plan to read this series in chronological order like I did, I'd love to know about it in the comment section below. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe to my channel so you can see the next time I post a video. And in the meantime, enjoy reading.